I will share my screen and try to find my slides.
Добрый день.
Okay.
Добрый день.
The title of my talk is Intermittency of Local Times in Geometry of Mass Distribution. I'm going to discuss the behavior of the random curve in the stochastic flow. Why this is interesting? Because the random curves are one of the mathematical models for linear polymer. It is known that a linear polymer consists of a lot of monomers which are connected in a line by the chemical bonds. These chemical bonds are flexible. So the shape of polymer changes with the time, changes instantly. Here we see some examples. What is the reason of such change? The first one you mentioned, it is flexibility of chemical bonds between neighbors monomers. Moreover, this chemical bonds allows only several positions. They looks like triggers. These triggers switches very often. We have to take into account influence of external force, like random contacts with the molecules of media. These molecules push monomers in the line of polymer move in different directions. Also, it is very important that different part of polymer, which are far one from another in the line of the polymer, can interact. This interaction are much more weaker than chemical bonds between neighbors, but still it influences on the shape of the polymer. So we have a random curve which changes depending on the external forces and the random media. What can be a mathematical model of this phenomenon? One of the possible mathematical description of the linear polymer is a random curve. For us, this is nothing else than a random process from parametric set, for example, 0, 1, and taking values in some Euclid space, for example, R3, from the evident reasons, Xi must be continuous random process. Finally, image of Xi 0, 1 under the mapping Xi is our random curve. What are the main features of such random curves? Usually this Xi is non-smooth and gamma has a complicated fractal structure. For example, here you see a picture of Brownian motion in two dimensions. Here we see how complicated its structure is. Why Brownian motion? Because when we try to describe probability distribution on the curves which must model the linear polymer, we have to take into account energy which we use to build some shape of the polymer. And usually this energy consists of two parts. The one is related to the interaction between neighbors. And it is common in physics to say that this interaction obeys Hooke's law. So we have the first term in the energy like a sum of, say, xk minus xk minus 1 norm in square. So we have a part of Gaussian density. From this point of view, the so-called free polymer model usually is just a Brownian motion in different Euclid space, different in the dimension. And another part is related to the interaction between different parts of the polymer, and on the mathematical language, it is related to the local time of self-intersection. But still, we have non-smooth process xi, so more or less we will have a complicated fractal structure of our random curve. So how we can characterize this curve? And one of the possible ways is the following. We just forget about the usual differential geometry because as we mentioned, xi is non-smooth, but one can instead consider the set of visitation measures. We take delta as a subset of the original Euclid space or as a subset of power of this original Euclid space and consider such visitation measures. Mu one delta is just the time which our random curve, our process xi spent in the set delta, and mu k delta is such like a common common time which differences xi t2 minus xi t1 and so on, xi tk minus xi tk minus 1 spanned in the set delta. It occurs that such visitation measures can serve as some, can characterize the random curve gamma. Some of these measures can have density. For example, consider a Wiener process in R2. Now it is known that mu1 has no density. Wiener process in two-dimensional Euclid space has no local time, but mu2 has density. It is discussed, in, for example, in the article of J. Rosen, local time approach to self-intersection of Brownian paths in space. In 1983. Let's denote this density like this, L2 of X, and it can be easily checked that this density has a full interesting property. Its expectation blows up near zero, like logarithm of the norm of X. Moreover, this can be easily checked, but also asymptotic of L2 itself without expectation is more or less the same as logarithm in the neighborhood of the zero. So we see that the visitation measure, visitation density, is not like density of uniform distribution. It blows up in the neighborhood of some points. It occurs that scientists studied such behavior of density of mass distribution a long time ago. And maybe the this article of Zeldovich, Molchanov, Rozmaikin, and Sokolov was the first one where such definition arise. Some specific structures in which a growing quantity H's record high values typically arise for instabilities in random media. Despite the rarity of this concentration, they dominate the integral characteristic of the growing quantity, mean value, the mean square value, etc. The appearance of such structures is called intermittency. So we have seen that we have such enormously high values for density, for visitation density of the random curves, which are modeling polymers, linear polymers. And it occurs that this phenomena is widely studied now. For example, one can see the article of Chen, Diagyang, and Semitindel, moment estimating for some renormalized parabolic Anderson models. In this paper, they exactly studied phenomena of intermittency because the ratio of the different moments of the local time or self-intersection local time density for such model has the behavior exactly as discussed Zeldovich and Molchanov. But nevertheless, sometime when we have such random structure which arise in the random media under the external force, it occurs that it gives us a nice geometric picture. For example, you can see such a photo which was done from Juna in 2018, and here we have a geometric structure for vortices on Jupiter. So also the same we can see in the chaotic structure of linear polymers. Usually when we consider DNA or even some not natural but artificial say polymers, they demonstrate not arbitrary shape, but some regular shape, even being in some stochastic flow, in some random media. So from this discussion, we have the main questions of my talk. The first one, how a simple geometric structure can arise in non-smooth curve under its motion? And by the way, how to describe this simple geometric structure when we have a complicated fractal random curve? Also, how the visitation measures of the curve reflect this geometric structure? And what happens with the densities of visitation measures when a random curve have such simple geometric structure? So the last question is in some sense description of this phenomena of intermittency for visitation measures. So let's begin with the motion of random curve. I propose to use for description of the motion equation with interaction. Such equation were proposed by me, and they describe the motion of the measure in the phase space. And here is the reference on my book where such equation were studied. Here is the equation with interaction. In this equation, we see, as usual, in stochastic differential equation, the infinitesimal increments of the coordinates of the particle which start from the point u at the moment t is equal to the sum of two summands. The first one is the drift A, but now this drift depend on the x on the position of the particle x u t and on the measure on the mass distribution u t which we will discuss further dt, and the next term also is more or less usual for stochastic differential equation. It contains, instead of one Wiener process, infinite number of Wiener processes which are united into a Wiener sheet, and here we have also dependence on the measure mu t. What is measure mu t? We start simultaneously from the all points of the space. So at the x u zero is equal to u for all u from R d. And now we have initial mass distribution of the points of the particles in the space. And then mu t is equal to x image of mu zero under the mapping x. So this is a distribution of the particles at the time t. It occurs that using this equation, one can describe the evolution of the curve in stochastic flow. Namely, we can proceed as follows. Take mu zero as a visitation measure of the curve gamma, then mu t will be a visitation measure of its image at the moment t. So if we define mu zero from the set delta as such integral from zero to one indicator of delta psi s ds, then mu t delta will be equal to integral from zero to one indicator of delta from x psi s t ds. So we get new curve, which is described by the new random process x from psi dot and at the moment tt is now fixed. So this is a model how we will move our curve along the space. Such idea to describe the motion of the curve with the help of equationless interaction driven by visitation measure of the curve was proposed in our joint article with Alexander Nerin and Olga Izumtseva. Here is the reference on this article. Now we have to discuss a little bit the equation, because we need to have some conditions on the coefficients under which we can guarantee the existence of the solution. Let me recall you that if we have probability measures of some metric space, one can define a lot of different distances between them. One of them is the Wasserstein distance between probability measures on Rd. And this is such an infima for two measures mu and nu, where the set Q mu nu is all probability measures on the square of this Rd, which has mu and nu as the emergence. This is distance of the weak convergence, actually. Now we suppose that our coefficients are Lipschitz with respect to measure valued argument exactly in this distance. The question arises, can we have an example of such coefficients? Here is an example of such coefficient, which satisfies Lipschitz condition with respect to space and measure valued arguments. It can be organized with the kernel of interaction. Suppose that the function f is acting from the product Rd and Rd and takes its values in Rd and satisfy Lipschitz condition with respect to both coordinates and is bounded. Define the coefficient A, which depends on phase point from the space, this is U, and on the probability distribution in the space, this is mu. By the formula, it is equal to integral with respect to Rd of f uv mu dv. And it is not very hard exercise to check that now this coefficient satisfies Lipschitz condition with respect to both u and measure mu. But the form of this coefficient is interesting because it is like double potential, because potential of double interaction, because when we want to calculate something in the point u, we have to integrate this f with respect to all mass distribution. And it can be imagined, and it is true, that somebody can consider not only double interaction, but potential of three or interaction of any multiplicity. And the series from such summands also can be treated. So we have a lot of examples of such coefficients, and we see from this example that they came not from the pure mathematical imagination, but from the physics. Now let's discuss more precisely which coefficients we will consider. I will consider, firstly, and mainly in my talk, I will consider deterministic picture, even with without the noise coefficients. I will say some words in the end of the talk. So now I suppose that our Euclid space R3 is represented as a union of connected domains DK, such that the interiors have an empty intersection, and that boundary of DK is smooth. Now take a point ZK inside of every domain DK and define a vector value function V from C01, C1, R3, R3 in such a way that its restriction on the boundaries of our regions is equal to zero. Also, I suppose that V and V prime are bounded on R3. And for every U which belong to DK interior, the solution to Cauchy problem, this is this equation, usual ordinary differential equation with no interaction, just ordinary differential equation, dyt equal vyt dt, starting from the point u, tends to zeta k when t tends to plus infinity. So the picture can be like follows. This black borders remain unmoving, but if we start inside of our domains, we just tends to our fixed point zk. This is a structure related to differential equation, which is derived by the function v. Now I will consider the non-negative function h, which also is a class of C1 on R3. And have such properties that h and ih prime are also bounded, and also h vanish on the union of the borders of our domains. Inside of the domain h is positive. Now define our potential f. our potential F, is just a product. H of V multiply on V grade, V capital of U. Then we will start with the following coefficient A, which is defined as follows. This is the integral with respect to second variable, with respect to measure mu dv. The reason which we mentioned leads that A is a Lipschitz function with respect u and mu simultaneously in the Wasserstein distance which we mentioned. So we consider such coefficient. And finally, we have such an equation with interaction with starting a measure mu zero. And it is known that now this equation has a unique solution. And now we'll discuss the behavior of this solution in a case when mu zero is of special kind. Firstly, define the numbers pk, it is mu zero from dk, and then we have such an evident theorem. It's not too hard to check that this Wasserstein distance of mu t, which is mu t, and such a point measure, delta, which is concentrated in our point zeta k, tends to zero. Actually, it is expected. Let me show you again the picture. So we just put here some mass and it tends to our focus. I cannot say focuses, but our attracting points zk when time goes to infinity. So it can be checked that this statement is true. And now let's try to consider the initial measure. This is the visitation measure of the curve gamma parameterized by the continuous function phi. So now we are going to consider the shape, geometric shape of the our curve gamma. My idea is the following. Because of we have no hypothesis on the smoothness of this function phi, it can have a very complicated structure, but I will characterize its geometric shape by possibility to include or to inscribe in this curve some polygonal line of the fixed size. It is important. It is important of the fixed size. So, definition. The polygonal line gamma u1 un is inscribed in the curve gamma small if there exist such sequence t1, t2, and tn that phi tk is equal uk, k equal 1 to n. So this is a picture. We can have a very complicated curve gamma, but we just inscribe in this curve some polygonal line. And actually, gamma can have some small nodes on it and so on, but this polygonal line characterizes its shape on the microscopic level. So let's go further. Now definition how we will study the type of the polygonal line gamma. the polygonal line gamma U1, Un has the vertices from the set Z epsilon, which is equal to the union of neighborhoods of other attracting points Zk epsilon for some epsilon greater than zero if for every j from 1 to n, there exists such k from 1 to n grade that uj belong to neighborhood of zeta k. Now take epsilon such that for k not equal to j, this neighborhoods, epsilon neighborhoods of zeta k and zeta j have an empty intersection. You remember that the point zk and zj are placed in different domains, so we always can take such epsilon. Then, with the every gamma, which has the vertices from the set zeta epsilon, we can associate the sequence of numbers, just numbering the neighborhood where U1 is, where U2 is, and so on. And here is a picture. If we have such four balls, then the polygonal line, which is on the slide, is corresponded to the following sequence, alpha 1, and so on, alpha 5, 1, 2, 3, 1, 4, 5, 4, 2. Okay. And now, definition. In this case, we say that polygonal line gamma has a type alpha 1, alpha n. I must say that, of course, under fixed epsilon, it can happen that from the point of view usual topological invariance, like Vasiliev invariance, it can happen that the polygonal line which have the same type have a different topological type. For example, if this epsilon is great enough, then one can imagine that such can happen. But by the way, when epsilon tends to zero, this sequence alpha 1, alpha n, from some small epsilon began to characterize also topological type of the gamma. Now the main definition about the curve gamma. I just recall that the curve gamma has a very complicated structure because it is generated by the parameterizing function phi, which is just continuous, this all. So the curve gamma has at least type alpha 1, alpha n, if the polygonal line of such type can be inscribed. Now let's see what happened with our random curves. Suppose that random curves gamma t are obtained as solution to the interaction with the coefficient a. Let epsilon be sufficiently small such that all these neighborhoods are included in our domain. Define the function that RT grade, R capital T, which is equal to probability that gamma T is at least of type alpha 1, alpha n. Now, alpha 1, alpha n is just a fixed sequence, arbitrary. We just write it as a word with some letters, and that's all. And it occurs that this function RT has the following interesting property theorem. It occurs that it is not increasing function actually, but it is, I can say, almost increasing. Yeah? RT For every t which is greater than zero, rt is less or equal than this limit of rt when t tends to infinity. Actually, it follows from the following good property that if we have, let me just find this picture again and recall you what happened with the usual solution to stochastic differential, to ordinary differential. Here is this picture. The theorem follows from such a property that if we start from the sum compact inside of the domain dk, this convergence will be uniform. It can be proved. It's a theorem from the theory of ordinary differential equation, and it is well-known fact. So using this fact and using the form of our function f, you see this form and you see the definition of our coefficient a, one can see that the points of our curves will move along these trajectories of solution to ordinary differential equation, but with different velocity. And this velocity depends on the integral with respect to mu. So this is equation with interaction. More mass we have inside of dk, more faster we move along the trajectories of usual differential equation. By the way, this is a common idea how to get a much more complicated equation from some ordinary stochastic differential equation. And in my book, one can find the example when we get equation with interaction by changing time in the usual stochastic differential equation. And so we have such a property for this probability. Next what we do, this is an evolution of the initial winner trajectory. Suppose that we have infinite sequence alpha n. And now we will look for possibility to have such a type of inscribed polygonal line like alpha 1, alpha n, and n will grow to infinity. And it occurs that it is related to the excursion of our Wiener, three-dimensional Wiener process inside of the domains dk. So we have such excursion. And our aim is to estimate probability that for large values of t, we will have at least type alpha 1, alpha n. And it occurs that one can prove the following theorem. There exists some positive constant c such that with such relation holds this upper limit n minus 2 power on logarithm of the probability that from the sum beginning from the sum t gamma t will have at least of type alpha 1 alpha n is greater than this minus c. This C does not depend on our choice of the sequence. This is universal constant. And let me explain slightly this n minus 2 power. Actually, it came from a very, I can say, very good estimation from below of this probability, because as I said, we have to study excursion of the Wiener process into domains CDK. But we can estimate this probability from below, just supposing that we are looking for such very artificial situation when W in the moment K divided by N is in the domain indicated by alpha K. Using the independence of increments of Wiener process, we get the power N. So this is N minus one. And another came from the large deviation principle for Gaussian distribution, because we have increments of Wiener process on the small intervals of the length of 1/n. So we have not as usual in the large deviation principle N minus one power, but N minus two power. This is just explanation why we have such an asymptotic, but still it gives us some knowledge about the behavior of our random curve, because we understand that at least with small probability, but we will have a good geometric structure inside of our image of the Wiener process. So we have such a theorem. Now let's came to phenomena of intermittency. What happened with visitation measures? What happened with visitation densities of the our random curves when we evolve accordingly to this equation? And we have to follow the situation. Suppose that the visitation measure of order k, mu k, has a density Lk with respect to the Lebesgue measure. Then the same densities exist for every t greater than zero. This is actually a very important, maybe easy, but important remark. Because when we discuss, for example, evolution of the real physical polymer, if it is a linear polymer, then it can change its hermetic type only if it is like DNA, because DNA has in its construction actually not one, but two lines. This causes possibility of so-called self-crossing. When subsequently breaking this one line by line, DNA can cross itself without changing the order of these monomers in their line, without changing our genotype actually. But other linear polymers cannot do this. So when we place it into the random media, then one cannot expect that its geometrical structure will change with other Vasiliev invariant. If we have no nodes, we will not have it, but the shape will change. The same happened with our mathematical models. If we use this equation with interaction as a driving description of evolution of this random curve, one can see that we obtain a new curve as an image of the initial curve under the flow. And this flow is a flow of geomorphism. So we have no new point of interaction. So if we have, for example, some local time, we will still have it because of a change of Williams formula. If we have density of visitation measure of order k, we will still have it. So this is interesting phenomenon. By the way, if we need renormalization initially, for example, for Wiener process, for just calculate self-intersection local time, then we will need it further for any time t. And in the backward, if we need it for some time t, then we will then we need it for t equal to zero. Now denote by zk is a set of finite sequences. These are just differences. Suppose that in at initial time t we have t0, mu1, so our curve is such that its visitation measure from the union of borders of our domain dk is equal to zero. Then one can have such a theorem that for every delta which is greater than zero, we have such interesting behavior. This integral from the density of visitation measure of order k at the moment t, which is along the or R3 in k minus 1 outside minus the neighborhood of zk goes to zero. This is just some reformulation of the fact that we will have zeta k as attracting points. But from this it follows that more or less this densities lambda kt can blow up only in the points of the set zeta k, and that they must with t tends to plus infinity blow up in these points. So we have the picture like this, for example, k equal to n equal to, and we start from Wiener trajectory. You remember, we have one point zero where we already have something bad. So we will have the picture like this. We have two additional points, and our density goes to infinity in all these three points when t tends to infinity, not only in zero. So this is the explanation why intermittency arises. When we have some attracting points in our equation with interaction for our double potential, then we have the phenomena of intermittency for densities. Then one can inscribe in the, our random curve polygonal lines of the fixed shape and fixed size, which is important, not small. Of course, if you have the complicated fractal structure, you can find very small, very interesting polygonal lines inscribed in our curve. But I insist that our polygonal lines have fixed size. So if we look on the, our long molecular from the microscopic level, for example, we have microscope not from our century, but from 17th century, we just have this polygonal line. So we understand why this polygonal line exists, arises, and we estimate the probability with which this polygonal line arises. I must say that I consider it mainly deterministic picture without the random shift because of it describes the reasons much more clear. Now it is understood that if I add some small noise then which just perturbs our picture, we will have more or less the same statement about the shape of our random curve in the random media. So in my opinion, this is just one mathematical model which explains the intermittency of visitation measures or densities for curves in random media. And we have a definition how to describe the shape of the curves in the random media. And now I must say that sometimes it can arise as follows. Due to exactly the existence of attracting points, the left chicken. Okay, thank you for the attention. Maybe somebody have questions or comments, please. Okay, if there are no questions, then thank you for attention. And Georgi, who will be the next speaker?
Next speaker is Mykola Ivanovich Pertenko.
Okay, so again, thank you for attention and bye, up to the next week.
Thank you, bye.
Thank you, goodbye.